The busy schedules. Once again, I welcome to one and all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for the introduction, sir. And I take this opportunity to thank our college management, DBJN College Management Principal, Professor in Charge, Dr. Shakti Murugan, sir, and the head of the department, Dr. Narmada ma'am, and all the faculty members of Management Studies for giving me an opportunity to talk on this topic, business opportunities in India after COVID-19. So the technical session I'm going to chair on human resources and IT. And I'm going to, you know, like before the participants get into, you know, like their presentation, I'm going to share a few, you know, or it is going to be the service industry. The employees are not given with a proper objective. So again, when it comes for an objective, as per International Organization for Standardization, ISO, every company must share the objectives of an employee, and it must be known to each and every employee. And the objective, in the sense, I can take an example of 100% error-free metrics. 100% error-free metrics. You should not do anything wrong when it comes for a complex oriented process. When you're doing a complex oriented process, for example, a pilot or a driver. So what is the objective given to them? The foremost important, the safety measures. When they suppose when the bus is traveling from Chennai to Bangalore. So what is the objective of the driver? The safety measures. Okay, that is the target given to him, which is implied, but it should be explicitly given to the employees to know what is my objective, what I am to achieve. Most of the Indian companies, they don't have this objective, including services industry or even a manufacturing unit. So when it comes for a multinational corporation companies, they are adopting this. When you get into any of the employees' desk, they'll be having these objectives in their desk. What need to be attained during that particular 6 months? So there is an as a part of HR, when we talk on HR, there is a concept of performance.
It's a concept of performance appraisal, right? So performance appraisal, every 6 months, it has to be done mandatorily. So objective is, when it comes for an objective, it should be a smart objective, which is a realistic in manner. It should be a very specific, and it should be measurable, and it should be achievable, and it should be realistic, and finally time-bounded, targeted or something. So you should not give anything unrealistic. That's where, when you frame an objective for an employee, it is mandated that the process owner must know about what is their objective. The process owner will have a discussion with the top level management, because for example I am working in a college, so I know what is my objective, what I have to attain, whether it is a realistic or not. So when you give any objective, it should be a realistic in manner, and it should be an achievable. So SMART, smart objective. So next goes the new terminology, which is adopting. Brother, my screen is this time. The term called praxis. I think my previous screen is not displayed to you all. This is a slide which I'm talking about, the smart objective. Specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. And this is a praxis, P-R-A-X-A-S. See, we heard this term called proxy, P-R-O-X-Y. Proxy is nothing but giving, say, for example, attendance, college, we know, for our friend, we give a proxy. When it comes for praxis is nothing but copying made official. What you are going to copy from others. Say, for example, most of the people over here are from academicians and research scholars. When you write a review of literature, what we'll do, we will study what is know, like perspective when it comes for our research project. What is the previous study which was happened, and you quote the name of the person, and which will be displayed, which will be included in your research, right? PhD or MPhil or whatever. So similarly, when it comes for a multinational corporation, especially in US and UK, they have a concept called praxis. Praxis is nothing but a copying made official. They will be having a fair, that is in the kind of an exhibition. In a kind of an exhibition where they will exhibit their process improvements. They call it as a process improvements. See, praxis is nothing but whatever the best practices adopted by another company can be copied, but you have to quote the name of the company from where you have taken that. And it can be implemented in your process, either it is when education or manufacturing or any services industry, you can do this kind of terminology can be used. Most of them doesn't know what is this praxis. Most of the Indian companies, I'm just talking about business opportunities after COVID-19. These are all the terminologies need to be, you know, like familiar. It should be given to the employees. You know, like there are a lot of Indian companies doing their best, but which is not explicitly given. Okay, so this is what the terminology that they are using, Kaizen, K-A-I-Z-E-N. I think when it comes to total quality management, it's a Japanese term, which is nothing but K-A is nothing but process, Z-E-N is nothing but improvement. So it is a kind of a project can be taken up by the company, by the employee, for how they are, no, like the criteria which they chose is, like, say, for example, manpower saving. How many hours our manpower is getting saved when you do this process improvement? So earlier days, when you travel from one place to another place, the time duration taken for traveling, it's got drastically reduced due to a lot of improvements happened in, air transport or through road or whatever it may be. So KZ is nothing but process, KA is nothing but process, ZEN is nothing but improvement, which is derived from the Japanese term. And when it comes for a lean, LEA, lean is nothing but doing an unwanted process, eliminating the wastages. Like I can take, when you do a conference, when you are doing a conference, a prayer before the conference, what are you all supposed to do? You can do some sort of brainstorming with your team and you list down what are all the points. During the course of conference, what are you going to do? And after the conference, what are you going to do? So you have to do the brainstorming session where you come across with a lot of ideas and suggestions. So these type of a lean processing nowadays is happening in the manufacturing unit. I want, it has to be implemented even in an educational side too. We are doing a lot of process. We are doing a lot of accreditation where we are doing NAC or ISO or academic audit or any ranking. So we are doing a lot more things. So you should have a process manual to each and every process. When you are doing a process, you should have a process manual. That manual should decide how many time that you are taking for each and every process. And anything which is getting repeated or unwanted steps can be eliminated through by way of this practice of lean. So again, this is the terminologies mainly they are using in a manufacturing side rather than in either in a banking or insurance. Yesterday I went to a bank, it's just a 5 minutes job, but they have taken 2 hours to complete the process. So that is totally they are wasting their time, man-hour wastage, and it's also leads to it's not a good the time consuming for both the customers and as well as to the banker. So they are doing unwanted steps in between the process, so they can do a brainstorming and they can eliminate those wastages. And this is, I'll take another 5 minutes time, I'll wind up. So this is the new concept, actually, TGW and CCR. Again, this is not Indian terminology. TGW is nothing but things gone wrong. And CCR is nothing but concerns and corrective action report. So when you prepare this TGW, things gone wrong, anything went wrong, you should have a proper correction, proper preventive and corrective action need to be taken. And it should be properly recorded when it got happened. And who has done that error? Okay, and what is the immediate solution for the problem? That correction can be an immediate solution, but corrective and preventive action, which is nothing but the same error, should not happen again in future. You should have a proper control. I want to say that most of the Indian companies, they don't have a team called internal quality control team. When it comes for a manufacturing, you have. Again, when it comes for a service industry, you don't have a concept called internal control team. The internal control team, when you get into US or UK or Australia, companies there, it's a mandatory that every company should have an internal control team, ICT team. But when it comes for an Indian company, we have it only for a manufacturing, but for services industry, there is no quality control team is there, which is not officially over there. There are people who take care of another department, we lead this internal control, but there should be a proper internal control team there where they will monitor all such things, like what went wrong, what is the immediate correction they have taken, and what is the corrective and preventive measures that they have taken. So CCR is nothing but concerns and corrective action report. Any issues raised by the customers, and what is their solution, what you are it leads to a lot of projects comes across. I have done 3 cases in my previous MNC company. So the case and which helps us to reduce the man hour rate, and also it will improve our productivity. We can concentrate on some other activity. So this TGW and CCR terminology need to be given to it should be known. You have to give, it's an HR person to give training on such aspects like praxis that I have given, and Kaizen, Lean, TGW, CCR, and finally FIES, and again which very important. Okay, so what is this FIES? This is you can see the screen, FIES storage before and FIES after, how it arranged properly. And you can see this is an office where it's a manufacturing office, where you can see some green and yellow line over there. This is forming of, it is a path where the people have to walk on that particular path alone. This is a FIES need to be followed. There are a lot of examples. I don't want to take much time of your time. So this is a FIES terminology, again, which is first company which is adopted is Toyota. Toyota is the first company where they have introduced this FIES in Japan. So it's nothing but sort, set in order, shine, standardize, and sustain. So when you do all such things, and this kind of a training need to be given to the employees of industry, that is either it is going to be the manufacturing or a services industry. So you have to inculcate or transform this knowledge to your employees. Okay, so I have covered a very important part when it comes for a HR perspective. Like you should share the knowledge on praxis, Kaizen, lean processing, TGW and CCR, which is going to be a very important part, and finally the FIES. When you follow all such things, and you can give a training on such knowledge transformation, which helps all the business, irrespective of either it is a manufacturing or a services industry, which helps the companies to there are a lot more projects will come up, and it will lead to a goodwill for that organization. So that's the end of my presentation. So thanks for the opportunity. And now over to any questions. If you have any questions, please let me know so that I can answer. So if you have any questions, okay, fine. Thanks for patience listening. And now we can move on to the technical presentation. I hope the first presenter, Amrita, Jessica, Samson, are you there? You can unmute yourself, ma'am. I couldn't hear your voice. No, your voice is not clear. Thank you. No, ma'am. Maybe you can leave the room and you can rejoin, ma'am, so that we can go into the get into the next presentation. Sorry for that.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. Yeah. Now it's clear. Okay. Yeah. Now fine.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Then I'll go ahead and share my.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can proceed.
Thank you, sir. Is my PPT visible, sir?
Yes, okay. It is.
Okay, thank you, sir. I'll begin. Good morning, everyone. I'm Amrita Jessica Sampson. I'm pursuing my PhD under the guidance of Dr. A.S. Saranya in Ethraj College for Women. I'm presenting a paper titled Perceptions of Diversity in Indian Workplaces. Workplace diversity refers to employees with varying backgrounds, abilities, personality differences, and physical differences working together in an organization. The world is a diverse place, and there is beauty found in diversity. However, sometimes these differences, instead of being appreciated and valued, often become the main reason for discrimination and unfair treatment of employees. Therefore, organizations should make sure that they create a safe work environment and have proper diversity management practices so that diverse employees are hired and feel truly accepted in spite of their differences. In this paper, I have studied four dimensions of workplace diversity, namely gender, age, educational qualification, and ethnicity, as shown in my model adapted from Khan et al. 2019. Statements were taken, were measured using a 5-point Likert scale. Coming to the objectives of my study, objective number one was to examine the factors of workplace diversity. I used weighted mean for this. My second objective was to determine if there were any significant differences amongst respondents with respect to the factors of diversity on the basis of chosen demographic variables using t-test and ANOVA. The sampling technique that was adopted was purposive sampling. The sample for my study was employees of IT companies, since the IT sector is a rapidly growing sector and employees often have to work with team members in other states and other countries. The sample was 140. The sample size was 140, out of which 66 were male and 74 were female. As the tables show, majority of the respondents were less than 30 years old, and majority had up to 5 years of work experience in their organization. The weighted mean scores of the items under the dimension gender was 3.93, age was 3.82, educational qualification was 4.08, ethnicity was 3.35. The highest weighted mean score was for educational qualification, since the respondents had strongly opined that their organization hires employees with varying educational backgrounds, and their managers also give them tasks considering their skills and abilities rather than their educational background alone. The t-test was run to determine whether there is significant difference between male and female respondents with respect to the factors of workplace diversity. The results indicated that there was significant difference amongst male and female respondents only for age diversity. The mean score for female respondents was higher than male, which indicated that female employees feel more strongly that their organizations are age diverse. Multi-generations in the workplace can be used to good advantage, as each generation helps build and equip their counterparts belonging to another generation. The practice of reverse mentoring gives older generations the opportunity to learn about the use of technology and other modern tools from younger generations, thereby leveraging the expertise of both the older and younger generations. The results of the ANOVA test showed that there was significant difference amongst respondents with respect sorry, having varying work experience with respect to gender, age, and ethnicity. The mean scores indicate that employees having fewer years of work experience opined that their organization is more diversity acceptive. Studies have shown in the Indian IT sector that although more than 51% of recruits at the entry level are women, only 1% make it to the top level management. A gender pay gap also exists at all levels, and business leaders need to take steps to ensure that there is a proper support system for female employees to move up the career ladder at the same rate at which male employees progress. For Anova, based on the level of income, it was found that there was significant difference with respect to gender, age, and ethnicity. The mean scores indicate that employees earning a lower monthly income feel that their organizations are more gender, age, and ethnic diversity tolerant. However, there exists no significant difference amongst respondents with respect to educational qualification on the basis of income. Research shows that individuals who belong to a stronger socioeconomic class tend to have easy access to and can afford better education, which gives them the upper hand while being considered for a job along with a candidate belonging to a weaker socioeconomic class. Thus, it is important for organizations and business administrators to level the playing field and look after the interests of the marginalized members of society. Some of the limitations of my study. Diversity is a very vast topic, apart from the four main dimensions, namely gender, age, educational qualification, and ethnicity. There are differences in religion, differences because of physical disabilities, cognitive and personality differences, and differences in skill sets, etc. Diversity is also perceived as a sensitive topic, and sometimes people tend to hesitate giving honest opinions about such prejudices. The general limitations of questionnaire method apply. When confidentiality of responses is assured, the issue of authenticity arises. And finally, since most IT employees are forced to work from home because of the COVID-19 pandemic, their perceptions of diversity practices of their organization might have altered. Implications for future research. This was a cross-sectional study, but longitudinal studies can be conducted to examine whether employees' perceptions change over time and what factors cause such changes. Future studies can also include variables like inclusion. Diversity and inclusion should go hand in hand because diversity is only a quantitative tool, whereas inclusion is qualitative and the key for an organization to progress in today's world. I conclude my presentation with this. Diversity in the workplace should be seen as an advantage rather than a reason to discriminate individuals. In line with the theme of the conference, Business Opportunities in India After COVID-19, I think business leaders should conduct more diversity awareness training programs and take steps to reduce negative effects and enhance positive effects of workplace diversity, thereby increasing their organization's success and profitability. Thank you, DB Jain College and the Department of Management Studies for this opportunity, and thank you all for listening.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. It was a very good and neat presentation on your topic. And I have a few questions. So how many, your study is pertaining to IT company, right?
Yes, sir.
So how many companies have you come across? Is it possible for you to name the company's name?
No, sir. Unfortunately, okay. I mean, the responses were confidential. So okay. They weren't asked to give the name of the company.
Okay, fine. So how difficult you have faced while, collecting the questionnaire? Because,
Yes, sir. It was a bit difficult because it had to be done online. Most of it was circulated through WhatsApp, email, contacted employees through LinkedIn. It was challenging because it was during the pandemic, almost everyone's working from home still, and I couldn't go to the offices and hand over physical hard copies of the questionnaire. It was a challenging task, but God's grace, it's done.
And very surprising to see this 1% the female are taking to the top level. So it seems to be a very good finding, and good, and all the very best for your future career.
Thank you.
Keep going. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And we'll move on to the next presenter, Dr. Sindamani Avinash Ramesh, from assistant professor from BYK College of Commerce, Nasik. Sir, are you there?
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. You can start, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm presenting my presentation. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, sir. Go ahead, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay. Good morning to all of you. I'm Dr. Sindamani Avinash from Nasik, from BYK College, working as assistant professor there. The title of my research paper was Development of Entrepreneur Skill. So entrepreneurs are one of the important pillar in our Indian economy. Entrepreneurs are required to emerge as a source of employment creator and economic stabilizer. So entrepreneur and organizer of, or they are organizer of four factors of production. And one of the factor is the employment which they generate. Hence the entrepreneur skill, it is important, I think, to impart in our society through educational system. And this is the reason why I have taken this topic for the sake of presentation. So in this paper, I have tried to put focus on the various present opportunities and possible opportunities in the future through which the education system can provide skills of entrepreneurship among our students. So the objectives were to study educational history of India so that we can come to know about the areas under which these skills are already implemented or not. Second objective was understand higher education system in India. So in higher education system, whether entrepreneurial skill is imparted or not, that was another objective, to know the process through which entrepreneurial skills can be imparted among students, so that students may come to know about the skills and qualities of entrepreneurs so that they can take a risk and start their own business. Statement of the problem in this paper was the development of entrepreneurial skill is discussed, which is various sources and studies from where it can be imparted among the aspirants who want to start their own business. So role of education in entrepreneurial skill development, the first one is education stimulates thinking of person to start his own venture. So this is one of the role of education. Another one is education is the process of changing the attitude and mindset of a person from employment to employer. Education not only provides beginners knowledge, but also guides to present entrepreneurs who want to expand their business. Education explains all aspects entrepreneurs, that is finance, HRM, marketing, logistics. So these are the components of the business, and entrepreneurs should know somehow about these components. Education creates culture of entrepreneur society. So development of entrepreneur skills can be done through these two areas. The first one is education. Through education, classroom teaching based on curriculum, it can be done. Group discussion, seminar, workshop can be arranged so that students may come to know about the qualities and future prospect of entrepreneurs. Test and presentation, that is another one, through which education mode can give them the idea of entrepreneurial skill and they can start their own startup. Another part is training, so that they can have some training. The first one is field training. Under field training, they can go in the field, they can go in the factory or any company or organization and may have direct interaction with the entrepreneur so that they may understand the lifestyle of the entrepreneur and future opportunities of the entrepreneurship. Project work is another part. So right from graduation level or post-graduation level, they may acquainted with the project work, the research quality, and so that it will be also helpful in their actual life of entrepreneurship. product training, that is another part. So in product training, they may also come to know that the existing qualities of the product or possible market of the product, and may also come to know about the innovativeness which they can bring in the product training. Case study, that is another one in which they may come to know the successful stories of the entrepreneurs, and so that they may also understand the various opportunities and how they can have a good scope of entrepreneurship in future. So role play, they can also do it. So role play, under which they can act as entrepreneur under school or college level, and they can start, or they can basically go with the entrepreneurship. Meet the entrepreneurs, that is meet the entrepreneurs, it means the entrepreneur, any educational institute, they can call the entrepreneur in their premises, and student can have direct interaction with that entrepreneur in the educational premises itself. Business model building, that is another part. Every student will have to build his own business model under the training process, and he will present that business model to the college or that particular institute, so that his basic idea will be there. His imagination, his creativity will start to get inculcated in that particular period. So the conclusion of my study is that major educational institute, they should adopt, so that the knowledge and the skill of entrepreneurship may get inculcated. Entrepreneurial courses are necessary to change mindset of youth from employment to entrepreneurship. Educational institutes and universities should come in separate entrepreneurial courses, and these courses should be implemented at undergraduate and postgraduate level. Proper infrastructure should be available for, should be made available for this work, and can therefore it can be concluded that entrepreneurial skills development activity will contribute to the enhancement of skill in youth and economic development of the country. Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. A very good presentation, sir. I just want to clarify a few things, like the entrepreneurial development skill can be, you know, like inculcated to UG level of students or PG level of students.
Yeah, it can be inculcated for UG and PG level of students. But my paper scope and limitation of my paper was to study the courses which is offered under UG and PG level. Either it can be also imparted, inculcated from the level of school level also, and that will be better, because school level students, they have better creativity and imagination if we inculcate them. So it will be better from to start from that level also.
So since all we are academicians, what do you think about new education policy? Because you just talking about the entrepreneurship to be inculcated from school level. So, how good the national educational policy, the new education policy, how
one of the it is one of the area which is actually taken into consideration in this policy, that is activity based learning. So, in case of activity based learning, students' creativity and their imagination will be boosted, and this is one of the important thing while thinking or when entrepreneur think about innovation. So, innovation always requires creativity. And this creativity can be get boosted through this particular activity.
Good, sir. Thank you. And
thank you.
Very neat presentation. And thanks for sharing your expertise, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And the third presenter for today's HR topic is Dr. Vijay Gopal, sir, Vice Principal from Nalanda Degree College, Adilabad. Sir, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there, sir. Good morning.
Yes, good morning, sir.
So, shall I have the permission to share my slides, sir?
Yes, sir, with pleasure, sir. You can, sir.
Is my slide visible, sir?
Not yet, sir. No. Yeah. Now no. It is visible.
Yes. Okay, sir. Just I'm taking 2 minutes time, sir, please.
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
there. Just 1 minute, sir, please. Just it is a small network issue. Just within 1 minute, I'll be back, sir. Please, sorry. Because my system is AT. Good morning. Good afternoon, one and all. Myself, Dr. A. Vijay Gopal. Sorry for asking you, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir, audible, and your screen is also visible.
Yes, sir. So thank you very much, sir. Myself, Dr. A. Vijay Gopal. I am a vice principal and head of the Department of Commerce, Nalanda Degree College, Adilabad, Telangana State. And also, I am a professional director for Adilabad District Cooperative Central Bank. And I am a chairman for Ethic Committee, RIMS Medical College, Adilabad. And the CBE Financial Education Resource Person for United Adilabad District and organized 220 workshops. And even I have served as an NCC NSS officer for the period of 16 years and received a district, university and state level awards and rewards. And it's a really a great pleasure. And first of all, I would like to touch my forehead to the lotus feet of Almighty, as well as my teachers and all my parents and respected the chief guest of this auspicious occasion and the management of Dr. D.B. Jain College. And I'm very privileged for me for getting this opportunity to share my views. And the topic which I have chosen is employees' behavior and challenges. So whatever the paper I have presented, the article which I have presented, actually not by reading the newspapers, not by listening the TVs and all. So I was practically involved when the pandemic situation was, occurred. And practically I involved in the market and in the society. And by interacting with the various people, so by gathering their opinions, and I am submitting my expressions through this employees' behavior and challenges during this post-pandemic. So no one has expected such abnormal situation that everyone is going to face, and everyone economically and physically as well as societally in all the ways we suffer. So, but even it taught this pandemic situation has taught a very great lesson to each and every person. As according to that minister, how he said nicely, success is not final and failure is not fatal. Though we come down, it does not mean that so completely our life is collapsed. But it is the way, it is one kind of a lesson to us to come up and to set right our all the situation like previous way. So employees. And some of pictures I am showing you because I came to know that some slides are to be should contain some pictures and all. So these are all the experience, the situations everyone came across and everyone has seen even now. So employee behavior and challenges post pandemic. So I am classifying the employees for my topic point of view into the three categories. The organization may be a sole trader or partnership or joint staff company, or it may be maybe any small or big or whatever it might be. So I'm classifying all the organizations, employees' point of view into the manufacturing concerns, trading concerns, and service concerns. Means the employees of manufacturing concerns and trading concerns as well as service concerns. So majority of the employees commonly they work under work in manufacturing concerns as well as service concerns. During this pandemic situation, so I have observed mostly the employees of service concern as well as manufacturing concerns have suffered very lot as compared to trading concern. I does not mean that the employees of trading concern have not suffered; they too suffered. But in the middle of the in a certain situation, they are given an opportunity to maintain their businesses. So economically, slightly, so they have come out. That is why the employees of such a trading concerns have not suffered very much. But frankly, the employees of manufacturing concerns as well as the service concerns have so suffered a very lot. So in you know, all the ways they have suffered very lot. And now by the God grace, even we came out from this pandemic situation. But even the things are going to be set right. But a lot of challenges are there. And this pandemic situation has given a lot of lessons to each and every employee whoever working either in a joint staff company or in a partnership concern or in a sole trading concern or maybe a small or a medium or large, whatever it may be. We can observe, so as I say, thousand of what we can understand through thousand words, that we easily can understand by seeing a single picture with that intention, just by using my slides, I'm briefing. So here we can see this slide. Among that age groups, commonly the 30 to 35, because nowadays everyone almost all continuing their education and they're getting the job and they're setting like their life after 27 or 28. That is why during this pandemic situation, mostly the age group between 30 to 59 people have very, they have suffered very, very much. And the persons can have a stamina up to 30 to 40 years. But after 40 years, physically, mentally, so employees are going to come down. So this pandemic situation, n number of employees, and during this age, they have lost their jobs and lost their confidence also. So that is why it is very difficult for them to continue in the same organization. Otherwise, if they lost their employment, so getting the new jobs or a new employment is also going to be a very tough task for such age group people. And apart from that, even in, we can see the men and women. Generally, the in our culture, still majority of the men so works and the women stay at home as a homemaker. But of course, the gradually the attitudes are changing. But during this pandemic situation, we can observe. And generally, I have seen the backward areas and rural areas or some other areas or the traditional areas. Generally, one men, man will work and the rest of all the families are so depending upon them. And women participation in the employment is are very less. So where the men people have lost their jobs and ultimately after this post-pandemic and getting the job or again, even they get the job, ultimately the opportunities of the jobs are also so slightly come down. So it is also going to be a tough target to them. And we can see the last two but one, the urban and rural areas. So due to the you know the development of the cities and migrating the people from the urban rural areas to urban areas, so ultimately the employees of urban people have suffered very much than the rural employee, because in rural areas they can now the certain government schools, government schemes are there. So in our Telugu, you know, we have the government scheme like Paniki Ahara Patakamu, nothing but work for food. So at least 100 days work under Atmanirbhar Abhiyan. So the rural people have got it, but urban people have suffered a very lot. And so it's going to be a great challenge for them. And apart from that, this slide reflects, so the challenges for the employees, especially unskilled and skilled. This pandemic situation proved that, so the employee should be skilled or semi-skilled, but there won't be any scope. So it given a lesson to such all unskilled people, so whoever have lost their jobs and who have struggled very much, and they have to improve. So at any age, there is no age limitation for learning or knowing or gathering. So that is why the unskilled, and not only the responsibility of the employee, so the government institutions or government officers or like the NGOs or any other the social, intellectual community, so have to concentrate on such unskilled, because in future if the same pandemic situation even arises, so ultimately they should not suffer. And apart from that, we can see, so the contractual and casual workers are more suffered than the permanent workers. So generally one good thought is there, so instead of drinking milk and running, it is better drink you know, water in standing. So likewise, instead of generally in casual work, labor charges nowadays due to the scarcity of the labors and all, they may be getting more labor charges. So they want to work on day wise or casually, and they are migrating from one industry to another industry, from one institution to another institution. But they may get more. But such a pandemic situation arises. Ultimately, we can observe this through this slide that the casual workers only suffered very much than the regular. And even this situation, this pandemic, we can see. And in the year of 2020 and all, our unemployment has gone up to 23.52%. But God grace, now it is come down to 6.53. Means it indicating that the things are setting right. But still, many of the employees are there who have not got the employment. Or those who have got the employment, still they are getting the very less or very mild salaries. And now this, I can show you this slide. And it's indicating that especially the employees of manufacturing concerned and employees of service concerned, people have suffered very much. And this bar diagram indicating that, so the people who have lost their jobs. And whereas another bar diagram is a blue color indicating that the recovery of the employees, means still the recovery is very less and as comparing to the lost. That is why, so as per the experience by interacting with all, and what the suggestions I would like to give through this my article. So government has to frame strict rules to the employees to compensate or help the employees economically if such a situation arises once again. And certain rules and regulation, even the employees lost their jobs. So some of the institutions are upset, and the same employer is not taking back that existing employees. So that is why such a rules and regulations are to be framed. And apart from that, self-employments are to be generated and encouraged instead of depending upon others. See, if we depend upon others, ultimately losing their jobs. And afterwards, again, getting back is very difficult. Instead, if temporarily they may suffer, but if they have their employment ability, and they can survive by their own. And I suggested some of the employees have died, and some of the families have lost their family elders who are earning, and the government has to so provide certain compassionate employment opportunities. And a new punishment policy has to be established so that no employer can neglect their employees during the such pandemic situations arise once again. And apart from that, so I suggested new industrial corridors. See, we have a lot of, India is the country where the manpower is very high, but opportunities are very less. So if more industrial corridors are established, ultimately, and in the future, no employee is going to suffer, and the confidence of the employees are going to increase. And lastly, I would like to say, there is no doubt that the employees, especially private sector, have suffered very much during COVID-19, because so the government ultimately, even they have not worked, so employees have received that their salaries, but the employees of private sector have suffered. It taught a lesson to everyone how to face and protect our health and wealth. So confidence of the employee has come down, but a necessity is the mother of invention. Like that, the situations, whatever the pandemic situations, so they made every employee strong and encourage them to find the new opportunities either by their own or from the society. So this is the concept I would like to share through my presentation. And so I would like to express my sincere gratitude to SERS and for giving me this golden opportunity. And if I spoke anything wrong, and I request for excuses. Thank you, SERS.
Thank you, sir. Very a neat presentation. And I can see that you are such an experienced person. You have allocated with a lot of new task. And only one question.
Yes, sir.
Since you are such a very senior person.
Yes, sir.
So, nowadays, you know, like they are focusing on predictive analysis.
Yes, sir.
So what could be in future, like when it comes for, especially when you talked about the government, I think government sector employees, I think they are not facing much problem.
Yes,
when
of course.
It comes for pay scale. Okay. But when it comes for a private companies, So what could be the next few years, how it is going to be affected?
So employees are going to be affected, sir?
Yes.
So definitely, sir, so job guarantee has to be given, sir. And even say, for example, one institution, college institution, I'm taking example of the education. So the colleges, universities, or private deemed universities are taking the fees from the students, sir, and are conducting the full fees they are conducting and online classes, but they are remitting only half of the fees. So ultimately, if it means paying less but taking more by the employers, ultimately the sufferers are employees only. So that is why in future, if such a situations even arise, so my suggestion is, so the how it was, the same procedure has to be continued even in the future, even such a pandemic situation arises.
Thank you, sir, and thanks for sharing your expertise to this forum. Thank you, sir.
So thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
I'm sorry, any questions from the audience? Sorry, I forgot to ask. If you have any questions, you can ask our resource person.
So I would like to share one more thing, sir. Actually, I came from a very backward area, and it's our Adilabad is one of the tribal and very backward area. I'm the first person receiving doctorate in United Adilabad district, and we don't know that article will be published like this also. I'm the mostly first person, so from my Adilabad presenting the papers and motivating my youth and the students and all. To I seen one one lady very nicely she presented. And so to share, so such a motivation to all our beloved students and youth, actually I am presenting. And my student, my son is going about to so join the job. But even of that, especially to motivate my area people, I am participating in such a workshop, sir. Thank you.
Great, sir, that you are doing a great job.
Yes.
Keep continuing, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Good, sir. Any questions? No? Okay, fine. Thank you. And we will move on to the final presenter. Jabba Samuel is a project fellow from Department of Commerce, University of Madras. So, Mr.
Sorry,
Samuel,
I missed it after I was waiting for the present. So I'm the last person, I think. So you told us final question.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. Sorry. Okay. Jabba's Samuel, are you there?
Yes, sir. I'm there. Sir, yeah. Shall I present now?
Yes. You can proceed.
Sir, am I audible? My screen is visible, sir.
Yes. Yeah. Visible. You can proceed.
Yes, sir. Good morning, everyone. This is Jabba Samuel from Madras University, and this my today I'm going to present a topic called a psychological well-being on online streaming. Because this project has been conducted done by me during my MPhil course. The main objective why I chose this topic, because during this pandemic or COVID period, many people have been forced to stay inside the home, and this online streaming has become a platform to get rid of the stress and anxiety which they followed. So, and this is also a two-sided of a coin, where when the technology get more occupying the people, there is a chances of putting yourself down. So that is a reason why you have to take in the sector of psychological understanding, because when a person is keep on watching any series or movies or anything, there is a chances that something the other the psychological getting the emotional outbursts or psychological affection or their mind will be fixed on certain series, because they have to watch. It's like addiction period it's been started, because we have been forced to stay inside the house for more than 8 months, and that is a reason why I have chosen this topic. And this is my introduction part, and the main application or technology which I chose for the study is Netflix, Amazon Prime, Hotstar, and OOTAP. These are the four Prime apps which has been running during the pandemic period. This technology has been very flourishing, and this also provide a new platform of business in India, because we are currently our topic is based on a business opportunities. This is also app development business and technology development business is one of the major business which has been stay inside the home. It doesn't want to see the people, but you can earn money. This is the main category of new launch has been developed, taken forward by many young minds. And this is my review of literature. I've taken two review of literature from Poland site because they are the two expertise in doing research in Netflix and Amazon. Because these people have started before a post-pandemic period. And they found that this Netflix and Amazon have been a very important role to capture the people's mind and to just become a new way of entertainment. And this is my objective for the study. I've taken the study to check the behavior of early adulthood and to analyze the behavior at risk of addiction. Because as the saying says, only a few limit. Certain things should be kept in a limit. When the certain things, when the things become a ruler or master, we are getting a slave to that. So as we are doing that, during the initial stage, Netflix, Amazon Prime, everything was a good entertainment platform for us to get a new variety of entertainment. Like sit in your home, in your couch. Many of them have become a couch potato. I have to say this. If I'm wrong, I'm sorry for that. And this couch potato become a habit of eating a food, have a Coke or something in your hand, keep your mobile in the left and have a Coke in your right hand, just keep on having a food and watching the movies and series. This become more addictions of addiction and their behavior thing that this first it was the hour of 1 or 2 hours of matter, but when you keep on watching a series, a 2 to 3 season at a day, it shows us, the sign shows that your behavioral addiction, you are being more addictive to that applications. So to analyze that, we have been taking a questionnaire more to that. And due to the pandemic situation, we have planned to have an neuromarketing way of study, like to check people, but psychological study, but we can't do that during pandemic. We have adapted our questionnaire method and my sample size is 220 respondents. And we need to study to view that how the binge watching has been being a vital role to in it has been increased anxiety, depression, and loneliness, and even addiction to that software. And theoretical review was taken from a very article because this first they are starting as a time killer to escape the reality. And self-control. These are the main things they have been these are the 4 3 initial stages to get kill the time because we are sitting at home. We have to say something to time pass. Right? For that is the initial stage they are getting inside this application and to escape reality. Like everywhere when you switch on as any turn the social media, there will be like a COVID died, some alarming phenomena is going on. So to get rid of that, this is the platform is provided some relaxation. Later on, this become a more influence to stick on with that for a longer period. And these are the 4 factors are taken for that: entertainment motivation, informative motivation, social motivation, escape motivation. Entertainment motivation was that to get rid of the stress and anxiety and loneliness. And informative, if you take some other series or in Amazon Prime or Netflix, have more informative section like Bad Boy Millionaire. It's in Netflix. It shows how that our economic bankruptcy has been happened, and many things been given in even in Amazon Prime and as well as Hotstar is providing some informative series. It's like it's like two way of process. You can get some information, you can have some entertainment, and social motivation. Like some of the series show about patriotism and a lot more things is there in that applications. And the last thing is escape motivation to get rid of your stress, which is being employed by the outside forces. And we have validated a questionnaire through Cronbach Alpha. The value is 0.89, which shows that our questionnaire is valid. And we use a statistical tool to validate this as percentage analysis, factor analysis, chi-square, and ANOVA through SPSS version 23. The percentage analysis show that in my study, I've taken 220 samples, as mentioned before. 121 is a male and 99 female respondent has been taken. And the age group was majority age group of adolescent, young adolescent, as per my objective. from 18 years to 25 year old have been major stakeholders of this online streaming technologies, because they are the key people and the targeted people who has been brought into this applications, and they have a well known influence, because we are in the technological world where you have everything in your fingertips. It doesn't want to go to anyone to get their suggestion or opinion. Google is there, then just go and Google it, you'll get it. In that way, when you go to your Facebook or any other applications, or even your Google ads will make you to, like, promotions will make you to get into this app, because 30-day trial is there, it's 3 months trial, everything is started. Because this app is not new to our Indian country, because it started in 2014. But during this pandemic period, this application has become a major stakeholder. And this is a graph which taken the recent Indian stake, which where this online subscription has been increased. And Disney Plus Hotstar is a major stakeholder of 41% of major stake has been taken by Disney Plus Hotstar, because they have a thing that our TV in your hand, because you have a star channels is there in Disney Plus Hotstar, and that gives them more entertainment aspect. And next comes Eros. Eros is not much famous in South Indian side. And rather, Amazon Prime and Netflix has been playing a key role to capture the market of capture the market of Disney Plus Hotstar, because they both, the foreign markets, are trying to capture the Indian market. So that is the reason why our major star films has been launched in these two platforms. And nowadays, this Amazon Prime is creeping up to the higher level, and this business become a wide opportunity. Like Amazon, when you get a 999 subscription, you have Amazon Music, Amazon Prime Video, your Amazon Prime membership, everything has been under one roof. So that is a key idea to capture the market of Indian people mind. So Amazon Prime is creeping up in the business, and Netflix is like struggling back to capture the market. Rather, Netflix is one of the best podium or best platform to see a variety of knowledge and culture. Sorry, not variety of culture which has been provided. Like around 15 language has been there in Netflix. You can watch in the Netflix application. And this is a recent study was taken in during 2018 launch. Hotstar has a major stake of 69%, and least has been taken by Netflix and Netflix TV. The limitation of study, the primary data has been taken, and many the thing is, one used to pay the subscription, and many has been credential of using that subscribers' passwords and logins. So that is the main thing, which only 10 people will be there, but there will be 1,000 users. So that is the main drawback that we had in on technological aspect of online streaming. And the response are rigid to comment on binge watching, because they think that whatever I watch is not, it's my privacy, doesn't want to comment on that. And my limitation was that particularly talking on a particular location of Chennai city, and we can't even reach out other states. And my recommendation is the age group category is much given in importance in the sector, but it should be prioritized that this kind of series or something should be have some age criteria, and it and the people should have the knowledge that there should not be much viewing time, because this happiness is little bit of time rather than you can spend with your families or some other thing aspect can kill your emotion outburst, and that will become a haunt that you can't get out the stairs, and you'll be like addictive to that particular web applications. So my conclusion would be that over the top is one of the reason over online streaming application is one of the best business, because your mobile and tablets will be your partner of entertainment. It doesn't want to go out, stay inside, get relaxation, and everything is good, but keep a limit that it should not be a master, and you are the master, and don't be a slave to any other applications. And this is and thank you for a wonderful opportunity, and once again thank you.
It was a very fast presentation. Thank you. I have a question. Okay, so yes, have you in your questionnaire, have you mentioned the age group? You have given an age group. I want to know whether those are employed or unemployed. See, you have given 18 to 25.
18 to 24, yes, sir.
Yeah, 18 to 24, how many percentage of the people between 18 to 24? From your question, yes, 220, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
50, no, only more than 109 people has been there in my, 109 people has been this, around the 15 to 24, sir. 18 to 24. And only half the people is employed because half the people is employed and half the people is students, student community, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Student community people.
Thank you for your presentation. Thank you so much. And any questions from the audience? I don't have any question. It was a very good topic. That is its relevancy to this conference. Good. And all the best, Ma.
Thank you, sir.
And we'll move on to...
Yes, sir, I'm S. Chitra.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, we'll move on to the final presenter, Ms. Chitra. She is a research scholar from Sri Chandrasekharanda Saraswati Vishwa Mahavidyalaya, Kanchipuram. Ma'am, over to you. You can proceed.
Yes, thank you. Can you see my screen, sir?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
I don't know why it is not opening up.
If you have it in your local drive, you can open, ma'am. I think it's a Google Drive, right? If you have it in your local drive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I have it in the desktop, but suddenly my screen got frozen. I was not able to do anything.
Anyway, you can try. If not, you can present.
What happened?
No problem, ma'am. PPT, even we can look at your face. You can talk whatever... no, like what you have prepared, you can talk, no problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. My topic is about the study of virtual design thinking approach for online classroom management enriching our school teachers and learners. This is related to the study topic is related to the secondary grade teachers that I have taken sample for study. And we have seen design thinking approaches mostly in the business situations where there are problems, where complex problems or ambiguous problems where you will try to solve with a predictive analysis with a possible solution. But why design thinking approach that can be implemented in schools? Because these there are a lot of pedagogy resources like mind mapping, lateral thinking, and those kind of researches is killing the learner's creativity. So here in design thinking approach, they can do hands-on activity. The children can know about their learners. There will be a collaborative effect. And also when you pose a problematic situation, they will improve their critical thinking, that is the need of the hour. Most of the policy that as per the NEP policy 2020, they actually for our the policy is focusing on the activity based learning and also the critical thinking skills that is needed for future. So with this, while implementing this design thinking approach, the students can have a collaborative effect. Their critical thinking skills will improve. And also, while approaching a problem, they will put in their shoes with the they put themselves in the shoes of the customer. That way, they will think, okay, if this is the situation, how they feel, how can we like that empathetic kind of approach can be developed, and emotional intelligence levels of the learners will also be fruitful for that. So I have taken why not virtual. There are design thinking methods have been implemented in K-12 students' education. But in India, it is there is among students there is no awareness that I have taken from the survey. I have taken from the Chennai respondents. My study is limited to Chennai, so from that I from the Chennai students they said that the most of the questionnaires the respondents are the awareness level for the students is very low. So, but the teachers are aware as per the questionnaire and the respondents' research. The teachers have the knowledge of design thinking approach, but they have the difficulty in implementing that into the classroom because of the fear of the curriculum, and also because since it is now an online classroom. So because of that also, they were not able to the collaboration effect with the in the online classroom. So it is not possible for the teacher's perception. So I have taken in my research study the perceptions of the students and the teachers, and about the perceptions of the students from the online classroom, they feel that virtual classrooms are engaging. With that online mode of environment, and their word processing skills also, they feel that they are improving with that because they are working more with the online environment. So these awareness can be improved for the learners. That is what I have found, and I have written as for innovation for innovative methods. The learners can understand. The learners should have that exposure to the design thinking approach. So this my study is I have done a linear regression analysis taking the dependent variables as the school is not my school gives me a wellness program related to design thinking methods. So that to the independent variables, it is difficult to arrange project collaboration virtually. So there is a linear relationship between these two variables. So from that linear regression, it is found that the students, the teachers are aware of the design thinking methods, but they were not able to reach with the students due to the challenges that they face in the online online mode of study. So other mode of analysis is related to the ICT skills, how they do the ICT skills, whether they are using the normal classroom effect or the flipped classroom. So most of the respondents are neutral to that flipped classroom. So I felt that flipped classroom effect can be will give more effect in the online classroom to achieve the collaboration effect. This is what I have done in my design thinking approach.
Okay, ma'am, very good. I know that without presentation is really, really tough to explain, but anyway, you have done a very good job. And my question, when I gone through your paper, actually your article, why you didn't taken government school students? You have, in your questionnaire, you have stated only private. Why not government school students? Why didn't you choose?
Yes, sir. We can actually more and more of government schools can be taken, but my feasibility of study for getting samples and that's why I have taken private school. So I have to get public sector. I have to get more into it, sir. I am not aware of getting samples. That's why.
So for difficulty for difficulty to get us collecting samples. Okay, thank you. Okay. Okay. Any questions from the audience? Any of the participants questions? No.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thanks for your presentation. Thank you, and all the best for your future.
Thank you.
Thank you. There are, I think, five presenters. They have given their research, and generally, you know, like the best paper award will be given on different criteria, like the knowledge that you have on the subject, the depth of the knowledge, depth of the content of the paper, and the clarity of your presentation is very important, so that it can reach to the, you know, like the people, those who are listening to your presentation, and how good your presentation, that is your PPT, and the time factor, and so the clarity and your paper. I have gone through all your papers, and I have got your got some idea about how you have prepared it. So I'm not going to disclose right now who has given a best presenter. I want all the five. There is all the five. You have done an extraordinary job. You have, because you know, like it's unique, right? Everyone, your topic is unique for you and as well. So I don't want to, you know, like disclose right now. It will be disclosed during the validity session by the seminar conference convener, Dr. Nanmara, ma'am. So with your permission, I take this opportunity to thank once again DB Jain College Management, the Secretary, Economic and Finance, Principal, and Dr. Shaktivel Murugan sir, my guru, my well-wisher, and Dr. Narmada ma'am, the conference convener. I'm happy that she's running this show through online, because every year, this is the fifth National Business Research Conference. Happy, keep, continue the same, and want all the faculty members, Dr. Anbalakan sir, and all the, you know, like everyone who was associated with this conference. You are doing a very good, excellent job during even this pandemic situation. Organizing a conference through online is really a very big challenge. So keep rocking, and I congratulate all the participants for your research contribution for this conference. And thanks this opportunity. Over to Dr. Narmada.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. On behalf of Department of Management Studies, DB Jain College, I take this occasion to thank the entire conference committee, participant, as well as the speaker for presenting their valuable research findings. I must remark a proficiency sense of gratefulness to our chief guest, Dr. S. Ganapathy sir, for sharing HR latest technologies like Proxy, Hazen, and other five. Yes. Thank you, sir, for your insightful and provoking address. All the participants are inspired by your sparkling words. Finally, I thank this session technical lead student, Vice President Narasimhan, and other student volunteers for rendering their commendable work and support to make the session a grand success. Once again, thank you, one and all.